The sovereignty and majesty of God elicits our praise. When we encounter God, we find him infinitely worthy of our worship and adoration. He spread out the heavens, and there is his glory revealed. He established the earth, and here is his greatness manifest. Yet sometimes this truth is clouded by the challenges of life. Sometimes we look at the news or we look at our own lives, and for all the brokenness we witness, we may wonder how we can really claim that God's greatness is manifest throughout all the earth. And as we wonder, there are any number of things or people or ideals that would eagerly step into that place of greatness and glory in our lives, redirecting our worship. They are the conflicting claims for power and influence, the things that the broken world or our own fearful hearts try to convince us will bring success and security. But the anthem we just heard draws on the scriptural witness, offering us an entirely different claim for power and influence. It makes the bold claim that there is none else but the God who created heaven and earth. He alone is worthy of worship. Even as we look back on recent weeks and months, we lament the presence of prejudice-born and fear-driven violence. We continue to reel from the impact of worldwide pandemic. And each of us still faces the challenging realities of ordinary life. It would be easy to believe that these things rule supreme in our world. And yet, this is exactly the world in which Christ finds us. This is exactly the world in which the greatness and glory of God is revealed and made manifest. So it is in the times when the world seems most threatening, when our view of God is most clouded, and we are most tempted to turn to lesser powers and promises, that we need to allow our hearts and our minds to once again be directed toward the living God in worship. We need to be reminded that indeed it is God who spread the heavens and established the earth, and even today remains sovereign over all creation, even over all those other things that would like to lay claim on our life. We need to be emboldened to trust that God is still at work throughout the world and in our own life. And because God's greatness is manifest throughout all the earth, we are free to worship wherever we are. Certainly, we continue to desire to be together once again, gathered in the sanctuary, joining our hearts and voices with the community of faith. Yet we know that even when this isn't possible, God is with us, continuing to elicit our praise and worship in and through our whole lives. So let us adore the ever-living God and render praise unto him. For he is our God. There is none else. Amen.